Hello, it's me, your nuclear DM.
Let's continue on our journey into learning how to run Lost Mine of Phandelver.
And now we're on to the hard stuff.
At least the stuff that's probably the most overwhelming. You don't really know what to do with all these NPCs. Just glancing over the town description of Phandalin, you see there's 8 people they mention. 9 if you include Karp. Kaelin Alderleaf's son, which they also just briefly mention here. They also mention that there's 6 people at the inn that the players could also talk to, which is a total of 14 people in this town, which is small for a town. You know, if you walked into a normal town, there's only 14 people. I'd be like, wow, this town's small. But that's a lot of people when all those people are being played by the same person, which is you, the Dungeon Master. Here's my advice for that. General, my advice is don't panic, take it easy, chill out for the most part, because everything's probably easier than you think. If your party is one to just be like, oh, we're in town, okay, whatever, and just maybe like check out the shops, then ask you, what do we do now? Just kind of mention like the inn. If they've done the Red Brand Hideout, which I predicted they probably would have before really exploring the town, then I would say anyone with a quest would probably just come straight to the party, because getting rid of the Red Brands is a pretty big deal, or they would be for the small frontier town with no law and order whatsoever. Would probably really appreciate that, to say the least.
Word travels fast around a town this size, and everyone would have heard that the party did this.
And what you want to do, I would say either A, pick just a couple NPCs and make them basically the quest giver NPCs that gets to the quest outside of the Red Brands. You kind of gauge what your party is like, and if they're more on the good side or just want to be heroes, then Lady Garail, the Harper agent, might be the one to come up to them first and talk to them, and maybe she'll have like most of the quest or some way to get to the other quest. Likewise, if they're more in the evil time, there's a Zentera agent that they can talk to, who works at the Phandalin Miners Exchange, named Halia, and might ask them to join Zentarum, who's basically a bunch of evil assassins. But if the party's more on the neutral side, I would suggest Darren Edermath, who owns the orchard, who used to be an adventurer like the party until he got an arrow in the knee.
I used to be an adventurer like you. Then I took an arrow in the knee.
Play it by ear, kind of. Like, plan ahead, but, you know, like, as you're reading through, if there's any NPCs that speak to you as, like, someone you yourself would want to get to know, or someone you yourself would want to roleplay, then definitely choose them as someone that the party can interact with. The other way to do it is just kind of look at the map of Phandalin and see it as basically another dungeon map. Every location that it's pointing to on the map, look at those like one of the numbered dungeon rooms. And just when the party goes to that location, that's when they interact with the NPC who's there. And not until then. They're not going to be able to interact with everyone all at once. Even if they split up, you have to take it one at a time. With all that being said, I still recommend that you go through this yourself and kind of maybe just pick out a couple NPCs or plan ahead. And also remember, like, whatever it says in the book, you can always change it. If you don't feel like role-playing someone the exact way they say in there, feel free to just throw it out. You can also just delete that character if you don't like them.
Let's discuss each person a little bit who's in town. Let's start with the inn, because the inn has 6 people, none of which really give out quests after the Red Brands are dealt with. I mean, some of them mention the Red Brands. Feel free to just get rid of all these characters. All they really do is point to other quests that are happening in town. The inn's kind of the hub of this hub town.
If the party is waking up in the inn, these people are meant to just kind of like give them a lead on what they can do next. But my advice is to instead have the person who has that quest just come up to the party and give it to them when they wake up in the morning. I feel like because the inn is, again, like this big meeting area, they'd probably be in the inn at some point throughout the day anyway. The quest giver, I mean. So, I would say feel free to just get rid of these named Stonehill Inn characters and just have the quest givers being the one there instead. I'll go over them really quickly. Toblin should still be there, though. Toblin's the innkeeper.
Innkeepers or barkeeps or shop owners are all good NPCs to always have at least one of in each town for you to roleplay,
because those can be like the people who always know what's going on in town and might pass along information to the party every day or every time they come visit that person. They could always give the party a little more information. Stuff like that. So outside of Toblin, everyone else I'd say get rid of, but here they are anyway. I'll just say their names and what they say. Narth, a farmer, says that Sister Grail has a quest for them. Elsa, a barmaid, says that Darren Edermath has a quest for them. Trilena, the wife of Toblin, talks about the Red Brands. Pip, Toblin's son, gives a clue about the Red Brands. Frida, a weaver, gives a clue about the Red Brands. I know it's nice to build atmosphere, but this is your first adventure, especially. You really don't need this many NPCs. You pretty much just need, like, one. One good one. You could have Toblin pretty much be the only person the party talks to in town, if you want.
if you want to make it like super easy on yourself.
Have him be the shopkeep as well. You make this really easy on yourself. You don't need this many NPCs for this simple adventure. Anyway, so that's the inn. Next is Barthen's provision on here. Note that he only sells gear that's not weapons or armor that's 25 gold or less in the player's handbook. He also has some clues. He talks about the Gundren has two more brothers. Roleplay that information how you want. But he's kind of useless outside of that. He can pay the party for delivering the goods if they get to him first. He'll mention the red brands, just like everyone basically will. And he has this clue about Gundren's brothers, but he doesn't give any more quests, unless you want him to. Next is Darren Edermath, the ex-adventurer at the orchard. He has one quest to give the party. He's also an Order of the Gauntlet member. He has one quest. I'll talk about the quest they give in the next episode. That's basically it for Darren. Anyway, on to the next thing. The Lion Shield Coster. Lenine is the owner of the Lion Shield Coster, and she'll give the players 50 gold as a reward if they either tell her about the goods that they saw lost or bring them back. But she doesn't have any quest outside of that. She will sell them all the armor as long as the players aren't a threat to the town. If you're eliminating characters, she's a good one to get rid of. She doesn't have anything for the party to do outside of the 50 gold and selling them armor. And the Fandolin Miners Exchange. That's where Halia is, and like I said, if the party is all evil, or at least a few of them are, you could have her ask them to join Centerum. The only job she has is to eliminate Glassstaff, but like I said in the last episode, probably got away. But you could do that as a side mission if you wanted to bring Glassstaff back. Next up is the Alderleaf Farm, where Keelin works, like I was talking about. She has a son named Karp who can lead the characters to that hidden tunnel that takes them to Area 8 in the Red Brand hideout. But she also has a quest to give them after that for finding her friend Radoff the Druid. Next is the Shrine of Luck. This is where Lady Garail is. She just got injured recently from a banshee that she was trying to bargain with, and now she wants the party to go bargain with that banshee as her quest. She's also the Harper agent, like I mentioned, and she can sell the party up to 3 potions of healing, which is pretty nice. The Sleeping Giant, where the players should have had that Redbrand Ruffian encounter if they didn't have it in the street somewhere. Same with the Trisendar Manor. That has to do with the Redbrand quest I talked about in the last episode. So the last thing I have to mention is the Townmaster's Hall, which Sildar takes up residence here and has multiple quests to give him. Same with Harbin's, who's already there. He'll send them to Wyvern Tor with one quest, and then when they cut back from that, they'll probably get the other quest to go find Cragmar Castle. And Sildar also has a quest about Yarno, who is Glassstaff, the leader of the Red Brands. Once he finds that out, similarly to Halia, the Zentarim agent, he'll want the party to then go and find Glassstaff, but instead of killing him, to just have him arrested, because he's a member of the Lord's Alliance, who's the neutral group. And that's basically it. Anyway, thanks for watching, and please like and subscribe if you want to see more, and good DMing.